3.9. Another one with just explaining and no math, basically. We can model both natural resources and polluting emissions as inputs into the aggregate production function. Y is ALL for 1 minus alpha minus beta, K to the alpha, R to the beta. However, when we look at data, we see very different trends. For natural resource extraction, the rate of extraction tends to follow the overall rate of production of goods in the economy. So we have on a log scale, time, we have Y and R. Whereas, for polluting emissions, the rate of emissions has typically tracked GDP up to a point at which after which time emissions fall rapidly. What is the cause of the difference? Okay, so the first thing I notice here is that I made this up this question before I did my research on the EKC and came up with a model, realized that it's actually incorrect or misleading to model pollution as an input. It is traditional to model pollution as an input, but it leads you wrong. Okay, and I realized that a year or two ago, or about a year ago actually, and that's led to some of my recent research that's hopefully going to be published anytime now. Putting that to one side, why do we see these different trends? So this trend, if we stick with this model, this trend comes from the fact that WR is constant. So the price of R stays the same as AL grows, K capital grows as well, you're going to suck in more and more resources into the economy. You choose to use more and more resources as they're not getting more expensive, you're getting more and more productive. And basically, if this drops out of the math, if you just look for the share of resources stays constant at beta. If the price is staying constant, to keep the share the same, the quantity must be tracking. That's one way of looking at it. Okay, what about for polluting emissions? Well, I'd have to look at the facet here, the suggested answers, because really, given this model, given growth, here we should have, this is why we expect the price of polluting emissions to rise. If we're modeling polluting emissions as an input, and then pollution should be constant. So we can't actually really explain this based on this model. We need the model where pollution is a byproduct of the use of natural resources. Not that pollution is the input itself. The natural resources are the input, pollution is a byproduct. Then, if we have that model, then the price of pollution is the sum of the input price of the natural resource plus the marginal damage of pollution in a well-managed economy. And that sum goes like this. So where that is constant, then you have this, and where it's rising, you have this. But in addition, we have alternative technologies which are less polluting or not polluting at all, and somewhere as this as this price rises, you switch and pollution falls. To sum up, not a great question given what's now in the course.